impulse, rather instantaneous. How every action that one takes is like a stone cast in the water. And if it's loving, that stone, you know, is cast in the water, loving action goes out and touches the first person that it's intended for. And then it touches another person, and then it touches another person because that person interacts with other people. And so on and so on. And every action has a reverberating effect upon every single one of us on the face of this planet. So if I had committed a loving action, it was like love upon love upon light. A loving, a purely loving action was the most wonderful thing that I could ever achieved in my life. This had more meaning than to have been a Rockefeller or president of the United States, or to have been, you know, a great scientist, and to have invented something just incredible. If I had committed a truly pure and loving action, it had reverberated throughout the stuff of every individual on the planet, and I felt that action reverberating through them and through myself. And I felt it in a way that is beyond what we can even feel ourselves on this plane of existence. So, the significance of one's actions totally changed. What was not important was anything that I had, you know, owned or known intellectual, you know, there's a sense of intellectual pride, not that knowledge is bad, knowledge is good, but what was important was the purity and the motivation of every action. And I was in a realm of reality in which there was no time, and in which there was no space, and in which there was no limitation that we experience in this reality. And so therefore, any words that I use, I ask you to please understand,
yourself from this point. If God couldn't show up today, and God sent you in the events that you are about to watch, what difference did God make in the lives of the events that you're taking place? It's a heavy responsibility, but that's what we're doing here. God couldn't show up today, and you never knew the difference that God made in these situations and what you're about to see. What difference did God make?
You don't experience God. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't. You don't experience God looking in the mirror, you don't.
I was greeted on the other side.
Love loves us, not loves us. So
isn't what's really beautiful thing about it. It's not to be understood, it's not to understand, it's not to get, it's to give. It's not to be loved, it's to love, it's not to be loved. That really is the essence of why we're here. Be like a child. Learn to love what you want. Love where you're at, where you live, who you're with. Love who you love. No, it's not who loves you. It's who did you love. And that you love secretly, just said prayers to you, to an enemy that you love from afar. It's who we love that defines us, not who loves us. So there's people out there that read St. Francis of Assisi's prayer, which you guys are familiar with. I can only paraphrase it, but it's really beautiful thing about it. It's not to be understood, it's to understand, it's not to give, it's to give. It's not to be loved, it's to love. That really is the essence of why we're here. Like a child. Learn to love what you want. Love where you're at, where you live, where you're with. Love and grow. No, it's not who loves you. It's who did you love. Who did you love secretly? You said prayers to you. What enemy did you love? It's who we love that finds us, not who loves us. It's not to be understood, it's to understand, it's not to get, it's to give. It's not to be loved, it's to love. That really is the essence. Learn to love what you want. Love where you're at, where you live. Love it's not who loves you. You love secretly, you said prayers to me. What enemy did you love? It's who we love that defines us, not who loves us. So there's people out there that read St. Francis of Assisi's prayer, which you guys are all familiar with. I can only paraphrase it, but it's really a beautiful thing about it. It's not to be understood, it's to understand, it's not to get, it's to give. It's not to be loved, it's to love. That really is the essence of what we do. Be like a child. Learn to love what you want. Love where you're at, where you live, who you're with. Love who you love. No, it's not who loves you. It's who did you love. And who did you love secretly? Did you send prayers to the enemy? What enemy did you love? It's who we love that defines us, not who loves us. So there's people out there that read St. Francis of Assisi's prayer, which you guys are all familiar with. It's not to be understood.